good morning. Welcome to Band Core and Stretch on your Wednesday. Can you guys believe it's Wednesday already?
It feels like it is, I don't know what day.
Okay, let's see who shows up today before I do some explaining. Always this awkward beginning to each of my classes, so just bear with me as I make sure I don't begin explaining things before somebody comes in. It's always why I give it a second. Good morning, Danae. So today we're using a band, okay? You can use either a flex band, like a stretchy band. By the way, we sell these at Kinetic. They're $25, and we have, this is a top of the line band, the Pilates Marathu band. They never break. I've barely ever seen one break in 6 years at Kinetic. So if you want one, we sell them. Or you can use tubing. That'll work too, okay? So what we're gonna do today is half the class is core, and then the other half of the class is stretch. Alrighty, who else joined us here? Cody. Good morning, Cody. Okay, so let's get started. I want you to grab your band. Our first exercise is strength, but a little bit of stretch as well. Take your band, fold it in half, okay? And then you're gonna fold it in half again. So it's folded twice and it's nice and short. We're gonna take it over your head, feet under the hips, reaching up to the sky. You're gonna side bend one direction, exhale to come back to center, and side bend the other direction, exhale to come back to center. Are you ready? 3, 2, and a minute. Inhale over, exhale back up to the top. Inhale, exhale. You're lengthening the obliques, then shortening them. Your way back up is the work. Coming up is the work. So it should feel like a struggle. Perfect, 40 seconds. Today I've got my dog hanging out with me. Spencer, do not chew that stuffed animal, please. You guys know puppies, they chew everything. I've lost 2 pairs of shoes. I don't know, so many things chewed already. It's all part of it. 20 seconds, keep it up. Good, 15 seconds to go. Try to keep your arms nice and extended. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Perfect, okay. You're gonna stand on your flex band. You're gonna be grabbing it in 2 hands and then standing up nice and tall. What we're gonna be doing is a wood chopper across. So practice getting the right spot on your band right here, okay? You can do the exact same thing with the tube. It's just that you're gonna be holding the handle rather than the edge of the band, okay? So go ahead and stand on it. I want you to stand on it with your right foot, okay? And then grab it in both hands. We're gonna be twisting, coming up nice and high. 1 minute on this side. Ready? Let's go. Twist, slow release. Up over the shoulder, slow release. Do not rush this. Exhale to twist, inhale to come back down. Exhale to twist, inhale it back down. 45 seconds. If you wanna make it harder, okay, 2 ways to do that. Walk your hands down the band, okay? Or move your foot down the band like this, so it's shorter. I can't get it over my shoulder there, but you can adjust that however you wanna adjust that. Now I have it too loose. You've really gotta find that sweet spot. 20 seconds, twist and look. 15 seconds. Before we do the other side, we're gonna break it up with a different exercise. In 4, 3, 2, and 1. Perfect, grab that band again. Fold it in half once, and then again, so it's nice and short. If you've got this guy, you're gonna do the same thing, okay? All right, we're taking it over your head again. Pendulums. What happens on a pendulum, okay? Is I tip over my side body and then I rotate my chest to face my legs and then I come up over my side body. So make sure you tip over the side first, rotate the chest to face the legs,
and then come up over the side. Are you ready for that? 1 minute. Feet under the hips. Reach it up. 3, 2, tip. Rotate. Come up over your side. Stay the same direction for 30 seconds, and then I'll tell you when to switch. Perfect. 15 seconds, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, switch direction right there. Other way, woo, tip over, rotate nice and big. Exaggerate these movements, exaggerate them. 20 seconds. Give me nice big movements. Stretch those obliques nice and big. Home stretching right here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, we're back to wood choppers on the opposite side. So now you're going to stand on it with your left foot, and we're going to twist right. Okay? Okay, find your sweet spot. Give it a test run. Test run it. 1 minute. Coming up. Shoulders back. 3, 2, twist. Slow release. Twist. Slow release. Come on. Twist. Slow release. So obliques, you have a few motions off the body that train obliques. Side bending, twisting, torso rotations. Okay? Then you know you're hitting your side core muscles. 45 seconds. Hey, great job. Twist it out, twist it out. 30 seconds. This is a great active recovery workout. The kind of workout you could tag onto a cardio day. 15 seconds. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Good job. I'm warm. I just got to drop a layer here. We're going to double that band up again. So go ahead and double it up or triple it up, whichever. Overhead is where we're headed back. We're going to do a squat overhead. So you can go double. If you're shorter in your arms, I have long arms. If your arms are shorter, you could triple it. Here's what it looks like. We're gonna squat with our arms up nice and high. As we exit it, we pull down and squeeze. Then we squat again. Then we squeeze the other side. Are you ready? 60 seconds. Coming up in 5. Arms are long, chest is open. Ready to push the booty back? 3, 2, let's go. Down. Squeeze. Down. Squeeze. Perfect. I'd rather you move slower. Get the glutes down. Reach those arms up, lift that chest. Yes, let's go. 45. Great job. So it's tight, okay? Opposite foot, about 6 inches your heel is from your glutes, okay? We're gonna kick up, lift the hips, and then sit up. We're gonna kick it up, we're gonna sit it up. Now when I sit up, my leg is hovering, it is not touching the ground. Are you ready? 1 minute on this side. 3, 2, opposite glute, the stationary leg. It's getting the burn, 45. Lift, sit up. This sit up is supported with that band, so it feels really nice. Almost like you're gliding out of that single leg hip bridge. If your foot slips away, just adjust it. It's gonna move a little bit because you're moving. So just adjust that foot. Keep it about 6 inches from your glutes. 30 seconds. Sorry, 15 seconds, we're almost there. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, switch the leg. 4, 3, 2, let's go up, sit up. This is my weaker side. My right glute's always been my weaker glute. I find it a struggle just to push through my heel right here and come into that sit up. It's like 10%, 15% more of a struggle on this side. What a great way to toughen up your weak sides. Come on, 45, up, push it. You're driving your energy through your heel. I could wiggle my toes right now or my foot on the mat because I'm not putting my energy there. My energy's in my heel. 30 seconds. Great job. Keep going. Lift. Sit up. 15 seconds. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Now put both feet in. I slid all the way to the back of the wall there. Both feet come in. Anchor your elbows again. Now we're gonna do a reverse crunch. Anytime you keep your head resting, you get the abs under the belly button. So if you wanted to do upper abs, you would keep your head off the mat. We're not doing upper abs. Keep it down. Kick and drop. Now if that felt too easy, move your hands down the band so you're holding less of the band. That's gonna make it harder. Are you ready? We got a reverse crunch to leg lower. 60 seconds, two moves, 3, 2, here we go. Up and lower. Do not let your elbows leave the floor. Kick, drop. What are you trying to do? Hips up, baby, get them up. The higher you can get your hips up, up. I'm using my core muscles more and more and more. Lift. If you can't get up there, let's say it looks like this. That's okay. That's okay. Guess what? You need to work on your lower abs. The toughest abs to train are below the belly button. They're tough. Let's go. 30 seconds. Come on. Up. Down. Starting to feel. I'm starting to feel right here. Struggle's getting real. Here's your last 20 seconds. 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great job. Okay, I want you to unwrap the band, double it or triple it, dead bug. This is a Pilates move, I love it. Coming down, imagine there's a table that you're resting your legs on, okay? Make sure your ankle is in line with your knee. If it's below, there's zero core action happening. Up here, and then take your lower back and push it into the mat. That's called a pelvic tuck. Keep your head resting, okay? Hold that pelvic tuck. That right there is core work, just holding a pelvic tuck. Keep your feet up, tabletop. You ready? Dead bug. We're not lifting the head at all. This is a safe exercise if you just had a baby or if you're pregnant. Not that you all are, but if you were, right? We're gonna push one leg out, reach overhead, and bring it back. You're stretching out your leg. You're kind of squeezing your quadricep to do it. Drive through the heel. Ready? Let's go. Clock's on. Push. Bring it back. It's like a bug that's dead on its back. That's why it's called dead bug. Creative, right? Come on. Extend with an inhale. Exhale to bring it back. Inhale. Exhale. Give me beautiful lines, beautiful lines. Pelvic tuck, 45 seconds. Push it, you're feeling it. Now, if you were to feel this in your lower back, I want you to lose the band. Place your hands under your lumbar spine and give me singles right there. Protect your lumbar spine a bit. Keep going, keep going. My band's all jumbled, but that's okay. 20 seconds to go. Feeling your abs, yeah? 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hug your knees to your chest for a little low back release. Good job. Good job, good job. Okay, coming up, we're almost done the core, working onto the stretch. Can you take your band like this or your tubing around both feet again? Both feet. We're gonna lay down again. You're gonna hold the edge of the band, okay? I'm down. I'm gonna come up, bend the knees in a V-sit modified, and then lay back down. Or up and extend out, tuck down. Modify. Advanced. Okay, are you ready for that? Here's your alternate, by the way. If you just wanna do a hold, you're gonna be here. Knees are bent, hold it. Knees are stretched, hold it. Okay, 1 minute. 4, 3, come up and bend the knees. 2, here we go. Arms come up, knees get bent, and release it. Come up, let it down. Let's go, up and down. Exhale, inhale. Great job. Up and down. 45 seconds to go. Tough move. If you've got your legs in full extension right there, that's hard. That's really hard. Come on, hold it. Take it down. Take it up. Take it down. Up. Woo, there goes my band. Keep going, keep going. I felt that coming. Oh man, I hate when that happens. Wasting time. 20 seconds to go. 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1 more, 2, and 1. Good job. Okay, come on your knees. Double your band up. We're going to what's called the kneeling matrix with the overhead arms. So band is doubled. Arms are overhead. I'm going to kneel, okay? I'm going to sit my glutes back to my heels, push up and squeeze them, and then rotate. Up, sit back, push them forward, and rotate, okay? I'll show you from this direction. 1 minute, take your arms overhead. 3, 2, sit back, push the glutes forward, twist, back up, sit back. When you sit back, long spine, chest up, back, up. If you ever want to make this harder, use a weight. Use a weight. It's a great little core exercise when you make it a little bit more intense as well with load. 45 seconds, up and twist. Up, twist, perfect, keep it coming. 30 seconds. That twist back kind of works the mid to lower back and the core, your obliques. 15 seconds, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're done the core work. Let's go on to stretch. We have 10 minutes to go. Okay, so standing up, I want you to grab your band. Stand up. This can be done with a flex or a resistance tube. It's just a little bit trickier because there's not as much stretch on it. I want you to stand on your band on one side of the body so that the end is quite short, okay? Then you're gonna really grasp that end and stand up straight. Pull your shoulders back. And then you're just gonna drop your head off to the side, away from the banded side. If you wanna use your hand, you can. What's happening here is the band is pulling your arm down and creating space in your upper traps. So you're trying to stretch that upper neck muscle. Never stretch to the point where you feel like it's pulling and it hurts, okay? Let the band off if that's happening. But try to relax the shoulder down and drop the head. Holding here, 20 seconds. So many muscles in your upper back and your deltoids attach at your neck, which is why your neck is tight or sore or tired or restricted if you've done shoulder work or back work. So this is a really great stretch to release all the attaching muscles on the cervical spine. 5, 4, 3, 2, switching, release that head, let it go, switch it out. Okay, so again, you're standing on it. The shorter my end is, the deeper the stretch will go, okay? So the shorter, the harder the pull. Relax the shoulder, drop your head. Hold, I'm way tighter on this side. I can't bend my head as far. It's very apparent. This is a way tighter trap for me. I'm restricted. So I need to actually do this quite a bit. And I need to be working on my trap release. And this is my favorite stretch to do it. This and the tennis ball. Or like a myofascial release ball are the best ways to get your traps out. Keep going. Hold that. Try to relax the shoulder. 15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and bring the head up to neutral and release the band. Awesome. If you have a wall close by, you're going to use it. If you don't, no stress. I actually have a wall right here, so I'm going to brace my band against the wall, take my opposite hand, stretch it out, and then look away from the wall. Let me see if I can give you a bit of a better angle on that. Okay, there's my wall. Whoops. Okay, so if you have a wall, go to it right now. You're gonna anchor it, pull your arm away, stretch. The closer my hands are to each other, the deeper the stretch in my chest. If you do not have a wall, arms out front, pull your arms apart and tuck your chin into your chest, okay? You're not gonna get the same feeling in your chest, but you'll get close. So if you're at a wall, hold that right here. Creating space in the traps. Woo, what a stretch at the traps. Your pectoralis major minor and attaching at the front of your shoulder. 10 seconds. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and release the arm on the band and then release the wall. Same thing on the other side. Stretch the arm, twist away. Not getting enough, move that hand up the band. Twist away. Make sure you're really pushing your arm into the wall. Brace yourself against the wall. Can we go 20 seconds? Make sure you're pulling this arm away. You're opening the chest away from the wall. 15 seconds. Good, let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and release the arm, and then release the wall. Good job. Let's go behind the back. So take your band. Again, the closer my hands are, the deeper the stretch is gonna be. Further apart, a little less. Behind the back, okay? And what we're gonna do here is pull your hands apart, drop your chin to chest. Pull those hands apart, drop your chin to chest. What are we stretching, Chantel? Your upper spine, cervical spine. Again, you can feel some back muscles attaching there, some shoulder muscles, trap muscles. It can be an intense stretch. If you need to let it off and then go back in, or if you need to feel it more, shorten the distance between your hands. Let's go 40 seconds here. Good job. Just breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. 30 seconds. Oh, 20 seconds. Body part. Good job. I actually cracked my neck there just from doing that. You bring so much openness to the neck with that one. Okay, let's go to a seated position. Have a seat. I want you to take the band behind your back, okay? Anchor one hand to the ground. I'm behind my shoulders. And then I'm going to stretch this arm up nice and long, okay? Again, the closer my hands are, and the tighter I'm pulling the band, this top side shoulder here, the one that I'm looking at, is getting me stretch, as well as into the chest muscles. Stretch and look up, 20 seconds. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, release the hand, come up, anchor the other side, stretch out and look up, open that chest up. Feel free to pull this arm back and then you're gonna get a bit more chest in there, or you can stack it above the shoulder and just focus on the shoulder. 20 seconds. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, two, release the arm, and then come up to center. Good stuff. Take that band out in front of you. Loop it around the back of your feet. Hold on nice and tight. We're going to do a seated hamstring stretch. So walking your hands up the band, pointing your toes back towards you, pulling on the band, and then lowering the chest, okay? So you're going to figure out what feels best for you and how much on the band you want to pull. You may be back here on the band and you're like, that's enough. You may be like me and get your hands right up to your feet, lower that chest. Feel it from your calves all the way to the top of your hamstrings where your glutes attach. We're here for another 45 seconds. Breathe in through your nose, big exhale through your mouth. Every time you exhale your breath, think of your hamstrings getting a little bit longer. Breathe in, lengthen the hamstrings. Almost there, 20 seconds to go. Stretch for each side of the body and we're out of here. So I want you to take the band and put it over the top of your foot and then lift your foot off the floor like that and then wrap it around the foot and grab it in that same side with the same hand as the foot, okay? And then you're gonna move your hands to the edge of the band so it's looped around my foot, okay? And it's cradling my foot right in the middle. And then I'm gonna take a step forward with my opposite foot. Sometimes the band falls off, so just adjust it. Throw it over your shoulder. My other foot is to the front. I'm gonna lean forward and I'm gonna take this and pull it over my shoulder so that I'm pulling my heel to my glutes. Deep stretch. If this does not feel good for your knees, okay, I want you to stand up, hold the wall, do the exact same thing, but you're standing, okay? Hip flexors right here, quadriceps right here, assisted. So I do this for my personal training clients. I get them to lie on their chest, I push their heel to their glute and I really drive it in towards their glutes and they get a stretch. This is just as good, if not better. It's kind of like assisted stretch. Let's go 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and release. Again, it is a little hard on the knees. So if you need to even give yourself a bit more cushion under the knee, go for it. The biggest thing is making sure you set it on the top of your foot. Then wrap it around. then situate.
If you wrap it around the back of the foot, it's gonna fall off. So make sure it's wrapped around the top side of your foot. You're here. You're here. Find your balance. Push forward. And then draw it in. Hold it here 30 seconds. Think of pushing your hips down towards the mat. 15 seconds. Take that band wide, take it behind your back, spread your arms apart, feet are wide, toes are forward, forward fold, fold here. Good, come up, open the chest to the sky in a back bend, head back down. Up into a back bend, one more time, take it down. And up, back bend last time, and release the arms, and there you go. Thanks for coming and hanging out in band, core, and stretch. Happy Wednesday. Have a great rest of the week. Cheers.